Up next, it's our third game of the day, our second elimination game, and this one is between the top two seeds in the field. It's the number two seeded, 31-27, 13-7 in conference, Quinnipiac Bobcats taking on the top seeded regular season champ, the 35-21, 15-5 in conference, Robert Morris Colonials.
The last couple of years,
the 2-2. This is swung on. Hit to left. It'll drop in for a base hit. One run will come in and score. Everyone else will stay put. Base is still full, but the Bobcats grab the 1-0 lead here in the top of the third. The 1-2. Into center field, base hit. One run will come in and score. Donahue got the stop sign over at third. 2-0 Bobcats. Base is still loaded with one out here in the third frame.
Good work.
And that drilled her. She'll have a bruise, but she'll also bring in a run. Donahue will come over, touch home plate. It's now 3-0 Quinnipiac. Schwartzberg, the 1-2 delivery. That'll get behind Heiberger, and she doesn't know where it is. That'll allow Calderon to trot on in from third and score. It's now 3-1 as the Colonials get on the board.
Out.
A two-run lead for the Bobcats. That's put in play. It goes off the glove of the third baseman, Figmick, and it'll roll out of the way, so no play made. Run will come in and score. The lead is now down to one. It's 3-2 Bobcats.
It's over. She was out.
Swing and a miss, and again, they have Evans caught in a rundown going home. The game is tied. Robert Morris makes the most out of their second life, and they're able to tie the game at three.
Championship round.
This is swung on and driven into center. It's caught. Alba tags. She's coming in, and she will score. The Bobcats take the lead. Runner gets over to third.
Extra head start running from first. The payoff pitch is a bouncer to third. Thrown over to first, and the ball game is over.
The Quinnipiac Bobcats outlast and eliminate the regular season champions. Quinnipiac advances to the final for the second straight year with a 4-3 victory in Game 5 of the tournament over Robert Morris.
12 innings, longest game in NEC tournament history. You caught the whole thing. What did you see from behind the plate throughout the course of this game?
Oh, geez. I saw a lot, obviously, but, you know, we just got to keep pushing through, and that's what we wanted. It was the debate between who wanted it more, and that was our team.
Alfieri starts this one. Schwartzberg, who did everything for you earlier today, comes in and throws 9 innings of relief. When you're able to do that, what does it say about her composure?
You know, I don't even know if she realized it was 9 innings. You know, you just go in there, and that's how you play. You just one inning at a time, you know, and her composure, that obviously showed right there.
What was your approach in the sack fly at bat? You step in there knowing just get the ball in the outfield.
I just knew to get the ball on the bat. That's all.
Ashley, congrats. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
Ashley Heiberger, the game-winning sack fly for Quinnipiac in the 12th inning, 4-3, the final score for the Bobcats as they defeat the host school, Robert Morris, and we welcome on Coach Fairchild, and what a game. There's no other way to put it. How do you coach one like this that's so seesaw back and forth?
You know, we've talked all year about the mental game and staying in the middle. Don't get too low. Don't get too high. You're going to get beat up a little bit by this game. That's why it's such a great game. It is, at this point in the season, it is a test of mental strength. And I couldn't be prouder of our team. We were able to stay in that game because we're tough mentally and we don't take things too hard. Sure, we get a little frustrated in the moment when things don't go our way or we make mistakes. And I made my share of them in that game. But we all are committed to just moving on. Mistakes are going to happen no matter how egregious they are, and one of mine was egregious. You got to just move on, and they're going to pick me up, and I'm going to pick them up, and we came out on top.
You told us during the week your trio of senior captains has really kept afloat, kept you guys afloat during the year, kept you composed during situations like that. The bang-bang calls don't go your way. Did those captains step up in the dugout?
Oh, no question. And at this point in the season, you also see juniors and sophomores following their lead and taking up some slack for them when they're giving all they can out there in center field, behind the plate, and on the mound. So every single one of our players, including those who weren't in the starting lineup, I heard say things that a leader would say, and that makes me the happiest of anything as a coach, is we've got a bunch of emerging leaders on the team. And you know what? When they get done with softball, they're going to go out there and make a difference in the world because they have experiences like these to look back on and be proud of.
You fall to LIU Brooklyn in game one of this thing. What's it like to get them again?
hey, you know, we love having another shot at them. They're a well-coached team. It challenges our coaching staff to come out with a good game plan and go head-to-head with them, and they got a great group of players. And he gets his team ready to go at championship time, and apparently we do too. So we're excited to be in a championship position is what we worked for all year, and they earned it today.
75 and sunny tomorrow, just so you know, no rain. I think it should be okay.
That's a relief.
Coach, congrats.
Thank you.